My name is David Sengeh. I'm a senior studying biomedical engineering in Curry House.
David Sengeh was a Harvard Engineering Sciences student. He was asked by the university president to introduce Microsoft creator Bill Gates during a student lecture. It was live streamed online.
Bill Gates.
Thank you.
What did you say?
The general theme was, well, Bill Gates and I are very similar. I went through this thing about, yeah, but I have dreadlocks. He's working on his own dreadlocks. I had $25 in my account. He had a little bit more. But the core of the message was that the reason why we did what we did was we cared about people.
Now, I think the thing we need to say and to bring out to our viewers, and they've probably picked this up already during this conversation, we should make it very clear that you are crazy smart.
I don't know if that's true.
No, well, I read that you got one of the highest test scores for standardized tests in Sierra Leone. Is that right?
Yeah.
And you won a scholarship to Norway?
Yes. I was given the opportunity to choose where I wanted to go to study. And there was Norway, there was the US, there was India and Singapore.
So why did you choose Norway?
I chose Norway. Because it was the most different from Sierra Leone. I wanted to explore the snow. Mm-hmm. I wanted to explore this different food. I wanted to be in a place that I could not even imagine how it would be like to be there.
So how did you get from Norway to Harvard?
So I wanted to be a doctor when I left Sierra Leone. Mm-hmm. I was going to be a doctor if I did not leave Sierra Leone, a medical doctor. And once I was at Norway, I heard presentations from colleges about this thing called bioengineering. And I was so moved by this. And what do you mean bioengineering? You mean biomedical engineering? You can be working with doctors and you can be an engineer.
So you applied to Harvard and...
And I applied to Harvard and I got in. And it was absolutely incredible.
Were you apprehensive at all about... I mean, obviously, you're smart. We've established that. And you were in Norway and you've always been at the top of your class. Were you apprehensive about coming to Harvard where you knew, and everyone knows, you're among the best of the best?
It was a thrilling thing for me to imagine that I can be in a place where everybody else was top of their class and everybody else was absolutely brilliant.
So you went from undergraduate at Harvard to where we are now, MIT Media Lab, and now to come full circle, you're midstream on this project, working on prosthetic limbs. You say it's about the people, like you pointed out, it's about making people's lives better. Talk to me about the impact you hope this will have.
When I look at my professor every day, Hugh, he and I are very good friends. I call him boss and he calls me brother. My professor is a double amputee. Mm. It does not matter who they are. It does not matter whether they are MIT tenured professors who have lots of money and who have bionic ankles, or whether they are Sierra Leoneans, a young kid who is poor and on the street. They all experience discomfort. The interface between their body and the prosthetic leg, called the prosthetic socket, is very uncomfortable. We have so much technology today to allow rapid prototyping. We have medical imaging that exists. We have MRI. So my professor and I are asking the very simple question: how can you make the design of interfaces for the human body, beginning with prosthetic sockets, be repeatable, be comfortable, be quantifiable using quantifiable data, and be easy to use, such that it does not matter whether you're in Boston or you're in Freetown. You just send us a minimum set of data and we'll ship you a comfortable prosthetic socket.
And beyond just giving people comfort, which is first and foremost important, you are in principle transforming people's lives from being passive to active.
This is absolutely very true. Being able to give somebody this comfort, this ability to be active, to walk around and not be in pain, is what's driving us. And it's really exciting because it's a global solution. It's not just a solution for Sierra Leone. It's not a solution for Boston. It's for everyone.
Sengeh is improving the prosthetic limb, producing custom-fitted, comfortable, and affordable sockets, which he hopes will be on the market within 5 years. He also designs his own clothes.
But I designed this shirt that I'm wearing.
And finds time to discover more of Africa's young innovators and inventors.
We do have the talent and young people within Sierra Leone, within Africa as a whole, to invent the future.